students and night class safety. Find out how students feel about it and what the university police are doing to help.
East Bay celebrates National Recreation Sports and Fitness Day put on by ASI.
And Cal State East Bay's BayFest was canceled this year. We have reactions from the campus community. All of this starting right now. Hello, welcome to Pioneer Web TV News. I'm Al Foreman.
And I'm Natalia Aldana. In breaking news, the Recreation and Wellness Center's basketball courts flooded Tuesday night due to a sprinkler bursting upon impact. The basketball gym is still currently closed. According to Krista Smith, director of the Ross Center, around 7,500 gallons of water leaked out and said, a property restoration company is on site working to remove any moisture from the floor. Once this work has been completed, the university and the flooring company will be able to determine additional repairs. Intramural sports leagues will also be postponed until further notice. All other facilities in the Ross Center will be available for use.
And Bay Area art students will have their work selected to be displayed during the upcoming Emergent Artist Exhibition at Cal State East Bay. A total of 99 projects were submitted by students at several universities and community colleges across Northern California. Now, these included paintings, prints, alternative process photographs, mixed media works, and drawings. 33 exhibits were selected to be on display from March 10th through April 14th at CSU East Bay's University Art Gallery. Entry to the event will be free. Many classes on campus are held at night. Oftentimes, students and faculty feel unsafe due to past events. Pioneer Web TV reporter Curtis Perry investigates what the university police are currently doing to tackle this issue.
With thousands of students enrolled in night classes at Cal State East Bay, maintaining a safe environment is a top priority for campus security. Keeping our campus safe at night is also beneficial for students living in the campus dorms. Some students believe that the security provides a very safe campus at night, while others believe more can be done.
I feel pretty safe on campus at night. Like, I think that it's pretty well lit. And if I had any problems at all, there are so many call boxes that are almost like within arm's reach that I feel like somebody would come assist me if I needed help.
Campus security provides a few different measures that help ensure the safety of students during night class.
My name is Sergeant Yolanda Harris. I work for the University Police Department. I've been employed here for approximately 6 years. The University Police Department is very concerned about the safety of our students, so at night we provide a number of services to ensure that the students feel safe. One of those is our escort service. You can be escorted to your vehicle or to your classroom if you feel unsafe at night.
Student feedback is welcomed and encouraged by security on campus.
So night classes here is, I don't think it's very safe because there's a lot of stories going on, especially in the school newspaper, about car thefts and robbery at gunpoint and knife point. And I just think there should be more security during at night, especially for a lot of students that take night classes. That's one of the reasons why I stopped taking night classes.
For more information on campus security, visit them at Library Room 1063 or call them at 510-885-3791. For Pioneer Web TV, this is Curtis Perry.
Though opinions among students and faculty differ on the issue, university police say they aim to implement as many measures as possible to ensure safety on campus.
The Peer Advocates for Wellness program on campus aims to promote awareness in health and to aid students in making smarter health choices. Pioneer Web TV Director Christopher McBride takes us inside the Health Center.
The Peer Advocates for Wellness program promotes healthy awareness and better life choices amongst our CSU East Bay community.
Focus in on particular topic areas such as nutrition, fitness, stress management, alcohol, tobacco, and other drugs, and sexual health.
With an estimated population of 14,000 students, CSU East Bay has seen an influx of germs, viruses, and other illnesses affecting the campus. Although students are aware of the health services offered to them here on campus, they have failed to utilize them. After speaking with some of the Paul interns about student health on campus, they addressed this ongoing issue.
It's because we don't prioritize health and fitness in our own lives. We prioritize classes, we prioritize maybe hanging out with friends or maybe, you know, doing fun stuff online, but we don't really prioritize our own bodies. We often take them for granted, and then, you know, later in life we'll kind of realize what we've done when we're, you know, when we're in college.
Knowing that student attendance continues to be a major concern for the health center, Paul has developed several resources to encourage the East Bay community to be more proactive about their health.
We're a part of orientation, so we go to transfer orientations and freshman orientations where we try to have contact with each student coming in. We table, we give out flyers and brochures, but we also hold special events, like we do workshops on just starting out on a college campus. How do you balance your stress? We talk to students about responsible alcohol use before they even come to college, so that when they step foot here on our campus, they know about our alcohol policy and they know about responsible drinking.
Though the number of students visiting the health clinic and laboratory has increased, the Peer Advocates for Wellness program are still striving for a campus-wide effort. Signing off for Pioneer Web TV News, I'm Chris McBride.
For more information, the program is located in the Student Health Center, room 122. Up next, we address the concerns of students on the cancellation of Bayfest and find out how East Bay celebrated National Recreation Sports and Fitness Day.
The Bayfest cancellation caused a lot of students frustration, and angry messages exploded on Facebook and Twitter. The sudden cancellation of the event cost East Bay a non-refundable $14,400 fee paid to the artists. Pioneer Web TV reporter Chase Thomas has more on the event.
The annual Bayfest concert is a Cal State East Bay tradition that many students look forward to every year. Unfortunately, this year's Bayfest, featuring the rapper Too Short, was abruptly canceled only one day before it was scheduled to happen. Angry and disappointed, a group of students briefly occupied the new student union in protest.
Bayfest concert
is more than just a concert.
It's more than just a concert.
This table of leaders made a decision for the students.
ASI Executive Director Randy Saffold said the concert had to be canceled because Bayfest's organizers had not sufficiently planned for the large crowds the event was attracting.
It really came down that we sold too many tickets because we misunderstood what the capacity for that actual room was. And then you add on top of that we didn't have adequate insurance, we found out 2 days before as well, to cover this also. It just made the perfect storm for why we had to make the decision to not have the concert just for student safety.
The event was supposed to have been hosted in the multi-purpose room of the new student union, a room that can legally accommodate no more than 343 people. 546 tickets were sold in pre-sale alone. But some of the student protesters did not believe this official reason for the cancellation.
I think they canceled the show essentially because they didn't like, one, the artist that ASI was presenting, moreover, the crowd that they would attract, that if they found a way they could reasonably disallow it from happening, that they would find a way to make it happen.
That's the irony of the whole thing. Actually, that debate actually happened a week before that. In the interest of freedom of speech and expression and knowing how much the students actually wanted to see this artist, we made a decision to go ahead and let that happen anyway, but then to start a dialogue about it afterwards to encourage any people that might have been upset about Too Short's coming to participate in an open forum discussion on misogyny and rap lyrics.
Student body president Christopher Prado said that neither he nor any other students were included in the decision to cancel Bayfest.
When the decision was made to cancel the event, a student voice, somebody who could really embody the strong sentiment against canceling the event, wasn't present at the table.
But Saffold said in an ASI meeting last week that the decision had to be made before it was possible to contact everyone concerned.
And the decision that I made on behalf of the board to protect it from liability, risk, and lawsuit was an operations decision. If you wish to take that decision power away from me, you cripple me in my role as executive director.
Whatever the ultimate decision for the cancellation of BayFest was, the result is disappointed students.
To have come here to a campus that doesn't have too much going on, and to have that be a concern to most students here on this campus who want to have some kind of campus life experience, the cancellation of this show is a real big slap in the face.
Chase Thomas, Pioneer Web TV News.
Now, ASI is implementing new structural system for large events like BayFest to ensure issues like this do not occur again.
ASI celebrated National Recreation Sports and Fitness Day, inviting students to participate in the day of festivities. Pioneer Web TV reporter Sherlyn Santos has more on this story.
I'm here at Cal State East Bay's Ross Center, where ASI has put together an event to celebrate National Recreational Sports and Fitness Day.
Founded February 22, 1950, NRSA aims to focus on the, quote, positive benefits of recreational sports, fitness, and wellness. NRSA has also encouraged all universities around the nation to help promote fitness and health.
National Recreational Sports and Fitness Day is important because it's the NRSA's founding day, and NRSA is our governing body for all of the intramural and fitness activities that take places on campuses and universities across the country. So the ASI Recreation shows its support by offering programs through the variety of intramurals, the row-off, and different opportunities that the students don't normally get to see because we offer them throughout the year.
ASI held many different activities today to create a fun and fit atmosphere for students to get involved in.
I like Recreation National Sports and Fitness Day because it gives people a chance to come in to get fit and also check out the Recreation Wellness Center and what we offer to the building and to the school as well. We have different events going on today, such as a Zumba party, the relay race today, as well as the Connect Bowling Game Challenge today. So there's a whole bunch of stuff that we have going on today. So people can come in, and we have fitness classes for free as well from 5 to 8. So people can come in and check out the building and enjoy the services that we offer, as well as the different activities.
This is a really great event because I want to get fit. And since after high school, I haven't really done that much active since last quarter. This quarter, I found out about this and a lot more opportunities to get fit during winter and the following quarters.
Ross Center is open Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 12 a.m. and Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. to help students and members stay healthy.
Today, Cal State East Bay students have come together to celebrate fitness and fun. I'm Sherlyn Santos, signing out for Pioneer Web TV.
Founded by the National Intramural Recreational Sports Association, this annual event aims to motivate students and celebrate the richness of sports.
The Game Cave in the Old University Union is not new to East Bay's campus, but not many students know what it has to offer. Pioneer Web TV reporter LaDio Mitchell has more about the Game Cave.
I'm here in the Old Union at the Game Cave, where students kick back, relax, and enjoy some games.
Students are unaware of the game room. It offers a variety of games and activities to relieve the stresses that the college experience brings.
So what is the purpose of the game room?
The game room is a place where students can take time out of their busy schedules to just relax, have fun, and maybe even meet a few new people. We have pool tournaments, lots of video game tournaments.
What are the hours and prices?
The game room is open Mondays through Fridays from 7 to 10 p.m. And it's $2 for half an hour and $3 for an hour.
I'm LaDio Mitchell reporting for Pioneer Web TV News, signing out.
Thanks, LaDio. Up next, Charlie will be here to give us the Pioneer Sports update. We'll be back in a short while.
Welcome back to Pioneer Web TV News.
There's a lot going on in sports, and our sports correspondent, Pioneer Pete, is here with the latest. Louder, please.
Sorry, man. I don't think this is going to work out. I'm sorry.
Welcome back. Pioneer Athletic Programs are gearing up for springtime competition, and our very own Charlie Kennewag is right here with the full sports breakdown. How's it hanging, Charlie?
Things are going well, both for me and for the Pioneers, but let's start with a little East Bay golf action. Coming off his first tournament victory as a Pioneer, men's golfer Chris Herzog was named the CCAA Golfer of the Week. Herzog won the Pioneer Shootout this week at Hidden Brook Golf Course and helped the Pios win their first tournament since they started competing in D2 back in 2009. Herzog and the Pioneers will be in action this weekend in Livermore at Poppy Ridge Golf Course. Well, last weekend, the Lady Pioneer water polo team made a trip to Colorado for the Colorado State Tournament. They won their first game versus Colorado State, 12-10, but were unable to knock off number 13 Indiana, losing 8-5. The ladies are now 6-7 overall and take on Cal State, Monterey Bay, and Fresno Pacific this weekend at home. And on the diamond, the men won 2 and lost 2 last weekend down at UC San Diego. Their overall record is 8-10, which isn't terrible, but their conference record is 2-6. This weekend, the fellas take on a 6-8 Cal State Stanislaus team. On the ladies' side, well, they slipped up a little this weekend, losing 3 out of 4 games versus Cal State Monterey Bay. The Pios now have a record of 12-14, but only a 4-12 record in conference. This weekend, the ladies play Cal State Stanislaus at home. So while all of us mere mortals just have to focus on finals and whatnot, our sports teams have to focus on finals and travel around the state, and in the water polo team's case, around the country, while focusing on finals. So good luck to all of them next couple weeks.
Yeah, that's tough. But I love springtime sports. You know, the weather comes, the sun comes out like it did a week ago.
As
and you
right.
go out and you enjoy baseball games.
Go out there, work on your tan a little.
That's right.
Exactly. Warm weather is always great. Thanks, Charlie. Well, that concludes another show for us here at Pioneer Web TV News. I'm Natalia Aldana.
And I'm Al Foreman. Thank you for joining us today as we bring you the latest in events and issues affecting our campus. We'll see you next week.